Hey guys, John Velasco here at E3 2016. I just checked out the Pico Neo VR headset. It's a quick hands-on look. So basically, the Pico Neo is a glorified Samsung Gear VR, meaning that it is an all-in-one system. You don't need a smartphone. It's built-in, basically. It's powered by a Snapdragon 820 chip. The displays in there have a resolution of 1080 by 1200 pixels. And it's all integrated, so there's no smartphone because everything's housed within. And it comes with, it's tethered with this controller. It looks like a Super Nintendo, Super NES controller. It doesn't have analog sticks, unfortunately, which is my one gripe, because for those space shooter games or even first person shooters, you want those precise controls, but now you're just limited to just the D-pad and all the other buttons. So basically, it's coming out later in the summer. They say it's gonna be roughly around $500 in cost. The headset itself looks very much like a Samsung Gear VR, but it's in a distinctive orange color. It's pretty comfortable to wear, pretty sharp when you look through the displays, and of course you have the controller, which is tethered to it. Now, I played a space shooter game. To me, it had nothing different from what you'd get out of Samsung Gear VR. The graphics, the visuals, the experience, all the same. It is static, so it's not like the high-end VR systems like the HTC Vive or the Oculus Rift, where it recognizes spatial movements. That it's just pretty static. You can look around in free space, but that's about it. You can't lean forward, lean back, or duck down, or jump up. None of that's going to be recognized by the system. But again, if you don't have a Samsung Galaxy device or a Samsung Gear VR for that matter, this has everything built into it. So if you guys want to learn more about the Pico Neo, you can check out our website, VR Source, your source for all kinds of reality.